I'm going to describe how to use an equation of state spreadsheet. Equation of state we're using is the Peng-Robinson equation of state. And what we want to determine is the saturation pressure of isobutane at 300 Kelvin. So the idea is if we look at a cubic equation of state like the Peng-Robinson equation of state, and this blue line in the diagram, this blue line represents the equation of state. It's dashed in this region and here. The only correct values physically meaningful are what I've outlined here in black. But what we want to know is how do we determine this pressure? We have the general equation of state and we want to determine this pressure. So we're going to use the properties of fugacity to determine the saturation pressure where we're drawing that horizontal line connecting the liquid and the vapor phases. So what I've done is list the procedure. We're going to use the critical pressure and the critical temperature and the centric factor. We're going to put those into the spreadsheet to determine the parameters for the equation of state. And we don't know the pressure, so we're going to guess a pressure initially. We know the temperature. And then we're going to use the equation of state spreadsheet to calculate the fugacities of the liquid and the vapor phase. And we'll use Sovereign Excel to adjust this pressure we guessed until the fugacities are equal for the two phases. And we're actually going to just calculate when the fugacity ratio is 1. Same thing. So what I'm going to do now is open the spreadsheet. This is a spreadsheet from the Elliott and Lehrer thermodynamics textbook. So here's the equation state spreadsheet, and I'm only focusing on part of the spreadsheet, so I've actually made those cells larger and the other cells smaller. And then what I've done is typed in the critical temperature, critical pressure, and eccentric factor for isobutane. And these I can get from a tab in the spreadsheet. And our temperature is 300 Kelvin. We don't know the pressure, so I've guessed 1 megapascal. And then if we look at the spreadsheet under volume, the larger volume is the vapor phase and the smaller volume is liquid phase. Part we're interested in is the fugacity. So the part we want to compare is fugacity over here. Fugacity for the liquid, fugacity of the vapor, not the same. At the pressure of 1 megapascal, we can see the value for the fugacity of the liquid phase is smaller, so this means we're in the liquid phase, we're not in vapor-liquid equilibrium. And so what we want to do is make these two fugacities equal, which means we need a lower pressure. Now what this spreadsheet does, it calculates the fugacity ratio, and this fugacity ratio then is what we'll use with Excel Solver. We'll set this ratio equal to 1 by adjusting the pressure. So I've opened Solver. Our objective is to set the value of E14 equal to 1. And we're going to do that by changing the value for the pressure. And so when I hit Solve, so let me move this so you can see it. If I hit Solve, it's solved for the fugacity ratio. It's made the ratio 1. The values are the same here. And this says this is our saturation pressure, 0.373 megapascals. Now note in this spreadsheet, I purposely reduced the number of digits being displayed compared to the original spreadsheet just to make it a little easier to see. But you can see we can very quickly determine saturation pressure using an equation of state.